Fine. So let me start today. A very interesting topic, client-side storage. So please make sure and also be alert because this is our lab experiment, week 2, regarding to the client-side storage. Okay. So let me start this. So coming to this topic, talks about the client storage, client-side storage. It deals with the web storage. Now, actually, for storing purposes, maybe hope in 2-2 we have studied DBMS, Database Management System. For storing anything, whatever you are entering, it requires a database. But without the help of the database, what we can do is, with the help of web storage, for every type of browsers, it gives some sort of the storages for you. In that storages, you can store whatever the web applications data you are entering, maybe a form data, maybe any session data or any other sort of things. If you want to store, you can store in this web storages. So with web storages, web application can store data locally in the sense in your browser, it will be stored within the user's browsers, whatever the browsers you are using, maybe Mozilla, Chrome, IE, Opera, or any type of browsers. If you are going to using that, in that browser, you are directly going to be using and storing this web data. Now, before HTML5, application data has to store in normally cookies. So you have some idea in the cookies, right? So in the cookies, in the sense, like whatever the things you are entering into the text fields of any browser, it will stores in the history. Storing in the history, nothing but storing in cookies. Directly when you are entering your email ID, just with the first starting letter, it will show the remaining sort of the email IDs which you are entered previously, right? In the same fashion, previously they are going to using the cookies. So if you clear the cookies, so automatically there is no sort of storing such type of things. So cookies can be deleted. Normally cookies can be deleted probably 1 month or 1 week based on the time set, how much you are going to doing, how much of times you are going to set for 1 day or 1 week or for 1 month. It will be based on the setting of your settings, it will be deleted. So cookies in every servers request whatever you are sending, that all things will be stored in cookies. So web storage is more secure and large amounts of data can be stored locally without affecting website performance. It's not mean like you're going to storing some data in the browsers. Because of that, it is not taking a lot of time to get a response for your request. Within the less time only, the responses will be get. So that the burden on the browser should not be there. So it's a lightweight storage. So unlike cookies, the storage limit is for larger, like at least 5 MB. But in the cookies, it will be maximum of 2 MB we can be store the data, right? But here it stores up to maximum 5 MB. And transfer is never, information is never transferred to the server because it is storing locally. So web storage is per origin, it like the per domain, per protocol, it is like only from the origin. Means domain in the sense like .com you are using or .co.in you are using or .edu you are going to using, whatever the domains you are going to using. And protocol, whether you can be use FTP, whether you can use the HTTP, whether you can use to HTTPS, what sort of the protocols you are going to using, that doesn't matter for the web storages. And if you see the web storages consisting of different types, it consisting of three types of web storages. The first one, session storage. Second one, local storage. The third one, database storage. These are the three different experiments we are going to be adding in week 2. So session storage, local storage, database storage. So simply the purpose of web storage is for storing web application data, unlike cookies. So unlike cookies, it is consisting of more space, and also the cookies will be deleted for based on the time period you're going to be setting. And as well as the performance also good compared with the cookies performance. And three types of web storages we are having. One is session storage, second one is local storage, third one is the database storage. Clear? Now coming to the first one. Before this is session storage. The first to talk about, first one, session storage. Now the local storage and session storage, whatever we have, the properties over here, the local and the session storage properties allow to save key value pair. Key value pair is nothing but for every sort of, for example, if you want to store your username, if you want to be store the username, username, user name is key. Value is, username is, for example, KK Bashir. KK Bashir is the value, whereas key is the username. So local storage and session storage, both the properties consisting of, it will store in the browser in the form of key pair, key value pairs. Key value in the sense, key means, example, username. Value means, username, for example, is KK Bashir. So KK Bashir is a value here. Username is a key. So it stores like key value pair. So hope you are writing the important points. If you are not writing the important points, tomorrow you have the lab. So this is a lab. I don't discuss again one more time the lab. Tomorrow you need to complete this lab as well. Week 2. So that's why please make some note points and be alert to listen the class. The session storage object. So this is the session storage. The topic here is session storage. We are talking SS. Session storage object stores data for only one session. One session in the sense, if you are running one tab in your browser, then it is called as one session. So the data can be deleted when the browser tab is closed. Automatically, if you close your tab, it will be deleted. Okay, so it will automatically delete it. So also look at the local storage property, which stores data with no expiry date. That is another difference between the local storage and session storage. So local storage, we don't have any specific time because locally it will be stored. There is no expiry time until unless forcefully you are going to deleting the data in the local storage. The data will not be deleted when the browser is closed and it will be available for the next day, next week, next year as well. Which one? Local storage. But coming to the session storage, whenever you are closing the tab, automatically the data will be deleted. Okay. So that is one more difference between local storage and session storage. Coming to the syntaxes. Remember, for all these three syntaxes, there will be a different, only some sort of changes will be there. The rest of the syntaxes, maybe for session storage, maybe for local storage, maybe for database storage, three will be talks about in the same line. Only small changes will be taken care. Coming to this, when you want to start the session storage, it will be start because the browser, whatever you are looking, the minimize, maximize button, closing button is called as a window. So window dot session storage, this is. So window dot local storage, window dot database storage. So window dot session storage, it is belongs to window. Now here we have syntaxes for saving, syntax for reading, syntax for remove, syntax for remove all items. So probably we are required the first three syntaxes for all three type of storages we have, web storages. So coming to the saving data, how we can save the data in the session storage is with the help of set item method. So set item method, already have the idea of about the Java. Session storage is an object dot method. So session storage dot session storage dot set item. So set item, already you are aware, methods can be starting character, starting word is a small. Second word in the method name, first character is capital, right? So it consisting of, as I said you, session storage and local storage both are having a key pair value. So here is a key, here is a value. Agree? Now, how to read the data? To read the data, just you can assign to a variable. Say for example, A equal to 10. So 10 is the data you are going to assigning for that. So reading is nothing but what? You are assigning something to another variable. So here, var is a JavaScript variable. Var is a variable data type to define it. Because JavaScript supports all type of data. So it's not like data types we have integer, float, double. We are not mentioning. Whatever the data you require, just mention var, var. So we are creating a var variable called as last name. For that, we are assigning session storage dot get item. So how to read the data from the web browser, from the session storage is get item method. So get item of, you just call the key value, automatically value will get. So no need to be have again two parameters here. With the help of key, we can access the value as well. So to reading a data from the session storage, we are using get item. To set or to saving the data into the session storage, we are using set item. So set item consisting of two parameters, One is key, another is value. Example, user and value is KK Bashir. So user is a key here and KK Bashir is the value. To get this data or to read the data from the session storage, we are using get item method with the help of key. So what is the key here? Here key is whatever the key you are mentioning with the help of the same. This key and this key has to match. Then only we can be get that same data. Here, if you are using here user, if you are using here user one, it not be match. So whatever the keys will be with that key name, it will be extract that value. So get item. How to remove is session storage dot remove item. So what you are removing? If you remove the key, if you remove key means what? Like is an address. If you remove the key, automatically the value also removed. So if you want to clear all keys, means not only can store only one key, one value, you can store a lot of keys, right? So if you want to remove all, you can use session storage dot clear, session storage dot clear method. So in this session storage, we are discussed about four different methods. One is set item for reading for saving purpose, get item for reading the data. Next is remove item is for removing only one item, only one key. Clear for removing all keys. So when you are using these methods, you need to be called with the help of the object. Which object we have here using a session storage is an object. Hope you have written the syntaxes as well. So four different syntaxes. Just I will wait 10 seconds over here. Please complete the syntaxes. If you not understand the syntaxes, it's very difficult for tomorrow. Right. Fine. Okay. So next is the local storage. So what's the local storage? It will stores. What is the difference of this local storage and this permanent session storage is? It talks about the local storage talks about it will be not having any expiry date compared with the session storage. So window dot local storage, there we are talking as window dot session storage. Now to set the item, what you are using session storage in the previous, now here local storage, set item key value. How to get the value means how to read the value, session storage dot get item in the previous session storage. Now here is local storage. How to remove, local storage dot remove item. How to remove all, local storage dot clear. So only one difference between the session storage and local storage is it will stores without having any expiry date. Which one? Local storage. Session storage having some time period based on the settings we set for 1 hour, 1 month or 1 week based on that. Okay, session means it will open one at a time. Once the session will close, means the tab is closed, automatically the data will release, deleted. But in the local storage, even though if you close your tab, even though if you close your browser, the data will not be deleted. Take the syntaxes of local storage. Same thing, just put instead of session storage, replace it local storage. You can write a statement like, if you already written the syntaxes for session storage, right? So just write a point as instead of session storage, replace with local storage. The rest of the thing is same. Coming to the database storage. So please make an alert here. Database storage, little bit of simple, some in-depth concentration is required here. Database storage, first of all, when you are doing the DBMS experiment, what you are doing, first you are connecting to the database. Next, you are going to be on that database, on top of that database, you are creating tables. Agree? That tables, on that table, you are going to be writing some set of queries. You are extracting. In the same fashion, here, first of all, we are going to be want to connect the database connection, the first step. The first step is database connection. How you are going to be connecting to the database is DB equal to. DB is a user-defined database object. You can also use DB1, DB2, anything. Open database is a function or method. It consisting of the totally four different parameters. MyDB is a title of your database. 1.0 is a version. TestDB is just for on which table, on which sample things you are going to be testing, test DB, followed by how much of the size of your database you are creating initially, 2 by 1024 by 1024. It is approximately, it is 1 MB. This is totally here, we can consider as if in the form of MBs, then it is a totally 20 MB of size data, right? So 2 into this total. So 20 MB of size you are going to be creating here, right? So in this fashion, totally 4 parameters is required for creating a connection initially in the database storage. So the first syntax in the DB database storage is, it is not similar to the session storage and local storage. Both that session storage, local storage are different, and database storage is different. So DB stands for here, database object. My DB called as title. Title means name of your database. 1.0 is a version. Test DB is for testing. So my DB, test DB is user defined. Anything you can change. For understanding purpose, I'm just using my DB. And 2 by 1024 by 1024 is called as the size. The size is 20 MB we are creating. So after creating a database connection, two basic functions we had to be run. What are the two basic functions? Is one is transaction, second one execute SQL. This is first one, first function transaction, second function execute SQL. Now both are going to for executing the SQL query. Transaction means what? In the DBMS we are going to be performing any, for example, when you withdraw a, when you are sending a money to, from one account to account, is a transaction. When you are withdrawing some money, it's called as a transaction. How you are going to be withdraw the money? You are executing some query there. Means if you are withdrawing a money, means you are inserting the card, that is first query. If it is a valid, the card, it will be go for next one. Second query, entering the password, another second query. Third query, the amount. The password is matched. The amount is the available sufficient. The entered amount, then you can draw it. So like this, we are running the multiple set of queries. After executing that set of queries inside, then only a complete transaction will be done. So for withdraw, minimum to minimum 5 to 6 queries we are going to be executing for withdrawing a amount. Like inserting a card is one query, entering a language is another query, selecting the saving account is another query, entering the password is another query, entering the amount is another query. After entering the amount, getting that amount, detecting from your account is another query. Getting SMS is another query. Like this, getting an email to your is another query. Like this, all sort of things will be, each is one query, it will be executed. If any one query will be failed, automatically it's not called as a complete transaction. Right? So that's what we have the asset properties. Right? So the transaction function takes a single argument here. So take the syntax, hope already have taken the syntax for open database. Now please take the syntax for transaction. So for on which database object you are creating the transaction? So on DB. So if you are putting here DB1, here also you need to put DB1. So we have created a database connection, database object DB. DB dot transaction of function of TX. What's the function? Now we'll write that function. As I said, we are using two different functions, two basic functions. One is transaction, other is execute SQL. So execute SQL is the part of transaction. If you already has given an example, right? For entire transaction, if you want to do for a complete transaction, this complete transaction, inside that we are setting some set of queries. So that's why it starts the transaction. If you see here, db.transaction of function of TX, function of TX over here. Get the syntax, function of TX. Now, inside this, we are going to executing an SQL query. Execute SQL function, which actually executes the query. So again, execute SQL function takes four different arguments. The first argument is this one, a string query. Second argument, an array of strings to insert the values to for placeholders for in string query. Third one, a function, once the query is executed successfully, we has to display message. The fourth one, if any query mismatching or any sort of error is there, then any error is there, the fourth parameter can use. So SQL, execute SQL function takes four parameters or four arguments. First one, the query means a string query. Second one, array of strings to insert the values for placeholders in string query. Third one, a function on successful execution of the query. Fourth one, a function on failure of the query. Example, TX is nothing but previously already in the previous we have seen. This is a function. So on which transaction you are running the query? TX is the transaction, right? On this transaction. So where you are running the transaction? On the database objects. Where you are executing the query? On the transaction, but not on the database object. So database object, on top of the database object, you are going to be creating a transaction. On top of the transaction, you are going to be executing a query. So like this, you are going to be doing this. So transaction query, that's why it is started with tx.execute SQL. In this one, what is the first parameter? A string query. Create table if not exist. Like queries is nothing but like already have done in the SQL, the same queries. How to create a table with the help of create, right? So create is a query, insert is a query, like select is a query. The same you are going to using here as well. Create table if not exist employee. What is the name of the table? Employee. So already you are aware the data type, the type of the data and value. So name is text data, ID is real unique, department is text, salary is real, address is text. So how many parameters, how many fields are there in this table, employee table? Name, ID, department, salary, address. Totally five different the fields you are going to be using over here. What is the second parameter? A array of strings to insert the values. Array of strings to insert the values means if you are entering, you are going to be entering, inserting the values. You are going to be entering some data into these fields, right? The name, the ID, department. That where it has to store in the second parameter. That is array of strings to insert the values. The third one again is a function. Again is a function. A function. The third parameter is a function. Function of TX. What type of function it is? If the query is executed successfully, if there is no errors in the query, then this successful function will be executed. The fourth parameter is, if you want to display any errors, you can use the fourth parameter is another function for failure. So for success, one function, for failure, another function if required. So last parameter is optional. Okay, so these are the four different parameters inside. The first parameter is the query. Second parameter is the array of the string which consisting of some values of that query. The third is the successful function. Fourth is a failure function. Like this, we are going to have the four different functions. Where we have started here, db dot transaction of function of tx. Inside the function, you are executing this query, tx dot execute SQL. Inside the execute SQL, again we have one more function. So like this, function will starts with open braces and close braces. Remember, so function within another function like this. Totally inside the function, we are using a method called as execute SQL. Inside the execute SQL, we are again using one more function called as successful function. If required, failure function as well. Okay, see the example so that you can get some idea over here. TX dot execute SQL for insert. Insert into where you are inserting. Employee data, employee table, name, ID, department, salary, address. These are the five parameters. Agree? What is the second parameter we can use here in this one? Not second parameter. In how to insert the queries, insert values. Already you are aware the values function. Values of name is what? VVV. ID is 1. Department is CSC. And salary is 19,000. address is Tirupati. Example 3 talks about select query. tx.executesql select star from employee. So whatever you are going to be selecting, like this, you can enter any number of records. You can insert any number of records over here. That whatever you are extracting here, it will be stored in the second one, that is array. And if it is executed successfully, function of tx comma results. Function of tx comma results means whatever you are extracting, maybe 3 records or 4 records, that records are going to be stored in this array. For this array, to extract this one, we have a parameter called as, object called as results. So what type of results, which results it is? Transaction results. So that transaction results will be available in results objects. So if you want to be extract any a particular field into that one, all the rows will be mapped to results object. So results.rows.length will be tell you how many number of rows, means how many number of records are available in employee data. So results is an object dot rows dot length. So rows is a predefined one. Length is a function, or we can call a predefined function to calculate the length of the table. And if you want to extract a particular column, results dot rows dot item. So item is nothing but to access a field inside the row. A row consisting of set of items, set of columns. Column is nothing but here item. Item of I dot name. I means ith row. So totally the row dot, from that the ith row, ith element, ith column dot name. So item of I. Item of I means the ith row of particular item, which consisting with the name, the column name is name. If you want ID, results dot rows dot item of I dot ID. So that ID will be in that particular row, ID will be extracted. So how many fields in the record? 5 fields: name, ID, department, salary, address. Clear? So see what we have discussed just now. We have discussed about the web storage, which consisting of, for storing the web application data, it consisting of 3 types. One is session storage, local storage, database storage, right? Now inside this, let me see the local storage examples, okay? So examples will be have see in the next part of. Meanwhile, let me see whether you are catching the things or not. That's about the web storage and also client storage.